In Italy, we don't really have the American dream, you know, from nothing to something to everything. I want to be the representative of, like, Italy for the American dream, but it won't be the American dream anymore, it'll be the Italian dream. From a normal family in a small village to one day everything. I come from a very small village, it's called Mezzo Corona. It's a 5,000 people village. There aren't many, in general, any MMA fighter. It makes something special because it's like, you feel like you have to represent them and make them proud.
I always wanted to do MMA, man. I grew up watching, like not grew up, but like I got into watching 14, 15. Fader, man, Fader was my idol back then. I was just like loving Fader. On his styles, he was well-rounded anywhere. He's like, everywhere he goes, this guy is comfortable. On his back, on top, standing, wrestling.
I'm a fighter through and through, and like I knew in day one, I know even more now, I'm here to make it to the top.
5 years, it can take 10 years, it can take 15 years, doesn't matter, I'll get there. That's a fact, and I know it already, no matter what. I accomplished my dream.
But the southpaw stance of Marvin Vettori comes out firing big shots. Inside leg kick by Richards.
Beautiful hands from Vettori.
Vettori fast. Now on the mount, this could be trouble. Tom Richards in big trouble. The power punches are coming down. He turns his back. He doesn't like the shots. He sinks it in and he taps. Beautiful work by Marvin Vettori.
I'm not surprised, motherfuckers.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna get things started. We kick it off in the middleweight division. Alberto Uda versus Marvin Vettori. Marvin Vettori, official weight.
Gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of Mezzo Corona, Italy, Marvin Vettori. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of Blumenau, Santa Catalina, Brazil, Alberto Uda.
Chrissy and Vanessa, Ariane and Brittany,
ready,
also
ready,
in the building. First fight, here we go.
green trunks for Marvin Vettori and the black trunks for Alberto Uda. Vettori is a southpaw.
Uda's got him turned around now. He's got Vettori clinched up against the cage, and he's lacing up one of his legs, tying up that right leg and looking to make the takedown here. He gets it. Vettori, strong kid. Look at that, back up, and then Vettori switches around. Vettori on top now, but he's in Uda's guard.
The Italian, Marvin Vettori on top. That's a good hand.
Yeah, that one got through. Now Vettori on top. Uda's tired. Vittori's got some space to work here.
Trying to pour it on late. UFC fans, choose your side with hashtag Meet the Ass or hashtag Conor McGregor in your tweets tonight. And unlock special Twitter emoji.
Vettori with a triangle attempt. Look at this.
Get it.
Look at it.
It's all over. Morgan Vettori wins his UFC debut.
Very nice. Very nice. That's a huge feather in that young man's cap. Submitting a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt in his UFC debut. Very, very nice. And did so off his back.
Declaring the winner by submission due to a head and on guillotine, Marvin Vettori.
Marvin Vettori, ladies and gentlemen.
That is one excited young man, and justifiably so.
Congratulations on the win. How good are you feeling? I mean, you made quite an impressive debut out there.
It's amazing. I've been working my whole career to be here, and that's what I was telling myself the whole time here. Like, I'm so happy to be here. Like, I want to be here. So, just yeah, awesome. And also to get here and get the win is that's what I was looking for, and that's what I will what I look for the next fight. So, it's good.
Well, a lot of people are saying it brings a lot of light to MMA in Italy. You're one of the biggest, youngest rising stars from there. How does it feel to sort of, in a lot of ways, have a whole country on your back in a sport like this and represent them on a stage like this here in Vegas?
It's awesome, man. You just like, you have to kind of canalize all the good energy towards where you want to be, like, and not feel it like pressure, but just like good energy, just to pump you, to get you in the right mindset once you step in. So that's how it was, and I'm happy that I have a whole country behind me.
How popular is it right now, the US in particular?
It's getting bigger. It's happening slowly, but yeah, like, we had a kind of a medieval age after Sakara went out, and it's been like a bit of a black age. But now another guy, Alessio Di Chirico, signed up, and also the gym where I'm training is a very good gym, is with Filippo Stabile, and now it's happening. I still always do camps at Kings. The last three camps I've been doing at Kings. But before that, like 6-7 weeks before, I always trained in Italy, so it's happening.
A lot of eyes on you. Are you equipped to deal with the attention that's going to come to you now that you sort of represent MMA in a lot of ways down in your country? Are you ready for that? How does that sort of, has that crossed your mind, the pressures that come with that?
No, I mean, it's good when you train, when you do stuff, when you put your, when you put work in, and people recognize it. That's what it's all about. Once it was harder in the beginning. Once you just like work and on the shade and the shadow, and like what you every day in and out from the gym, but nobody like really cares of what you're doing. Now that for sure I'm ready to show, and yeah.
Mark Smith, our referee for this middleweight fight. Beautiful Brittany, great to be here tonight. Antonio Carlos Jr., Marvin Vettori. Here we go.
It's where Vettori is right now, and it's what we're seeing from him. This is a big round for Vettori.
Yeah.
And he's able to do something here that Antonio was not able to do with him. Get him here on the
shots.
Ground, land some significant ground and pound.
See if Carlos Jr. can get a takedown here.
Yes.
And he does. A lot of pressure applied on Marvin Vettori by Antonio Carlos Jr. here in the third and final round.
Looks like he's going for a guillotine.
Those late finishes, not this time.
For the winner, by unanimous decision, Antonio Carlos Jr.
I mean, but Ando needs to keep up the pressure, start throwing more combinations, ending with kicks.
Marvin Vettori, a man on a mission tonight, closes the distance. Vettori has twice now split that Miranda guard with his left hand.
Both these gentlemen are extremely tired, both trying to finish out strong.
All Marvin Vettori for the winner by unanimous decision. Marvin, the Italian Dream, Vettori.
Everything is so
big.
Oh, hurt him with Vettori. He's looking to turn it on here.
That was a flush too. Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is a majority draw.
Now I gotta ask, is it the last style bender or the style bender?
Style bender, but you can just call me Styles for short. It's a mouthful, but I coined the name from a TV series called The Avatar. It made sense to me because Aang, the Avatar, had to realize his potential to be the Avatar by mastering all elements, which is water, fire, earth, and air. And I have to realize my destiny as just mastering all the elements of martial arts to be here.
But here's the crazy thing. You've been fighting MMA since 2012, 11-0, all finishes. Why did it take so long for you to finally, I guess, make your debut, get in the UFC? Was it because we heard that the UFC had been trying to get you for quite a while?
I really wanted to get my experience outside the UFC, and now's the time. I just feel like I've just hit my stride of my prime, maybe even like just in the cusp of it, and yeah, it's go time.
So here is the Nigerian-born, New Zealand-based Israel Adesanya.
Fighting out of Auckland, New Zealand, by way of Lago, Nigeria, and tonight he is making his octagon debut, presenting Israel, the last style bender, Adesanya!
Might be broken.
Yeah,
a lot of blood coming out.
Looks a little rearranged.
Thanks so much. He's been breathing. Beautiful job with that defense. He's starting to take Wilkinson apart with the strikes. That hurt him.
Not sure how much more Wilkinson can take. Adesanya to the knee. Now back to the hands.
Moving his head, but not enough. Spit blood on him. Yeah, this guy is done. That's it.
Israel Adesanya. So-so according to him, but the last style bender does it 12-0. He makes good on the UFC debut tonight.
Middleweights, I'm the new dog in the yard, and I just pissed all over this cage.
So let me ask you, when they present you with this fight, what do you think? I mean, he's this hot prospect that everybody is high on. So when they come to you and say, hey, do you want this fight? Do you think, what, I'm the next sucker or whatever? Like, what
I like this provocative question, but not at all. Like, I we'll see on Saturday. I'm more than excited for this fight, and I just think I'm way better. That's it.
This fight is three rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of Mezzo Verona, Italy, Marvin, the Italian Dream, Vettori. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of Auckland, New Zealand,
to go with the middleweights, Israel Adesanya taking on Marvin Vettori. Adesanya in black, Vettori out of southpaw stances in green.
Right now Adesanya's making reads. He's getting the speed, he's getting the timing of Vettori. He's taking his time, he's letting Vettori miss so he can feel what he's using, feel his offense, get his punch count, get his punch speed.
They aren't small reactions, look at that. He's drawing big reactions every time he faints.
Nice combo by Vettori to finish with the kick. Good body shot.
Body kick by Vettori. Seems to be comfortable in the stand-up. He just can't overextend himself. Look at how Israel just slides out of the way of his attack. This is what Vettori can do, though. He can't start watching.
Flurry at the end of round one.
UFC President Dana White in the building here tonight, looking on as Israel Adesanya makes his second UFC appearance against Marvin Vettori. Fifth UFC star for Vettori. Here we go in round two.
And the footwork is just apparent. That's a big difference. Footwork is huge.
Oh, Adesanya beautifully slips the offering from Vettori and lands a flush right.
Watch. Adesanya has to be careful doing that to Vettori. And he'll stop throwing that kick because he's throwing it so low.
He fakes and then comes over the top when the guard drops with an elbow. Beautiful timing by Adesanya. That was elbow.
Yeah.
That was legal. And he thought it was so legal.
He only said that because he was hurt.
Yep.
He said it because he was hurt.
Now Adesanya starting to showboat a little bit.
Vettori needs to get forward pressure and just attack.
He's got to fight.
Yeah, he does. He's got to be the
bully.
The bully, like you're saying.
You got to be a yard dog. You got to bite down on that mouthpiece.
Yeah, go forward. Because if he's staying at distance like this, what's happening?
He's losing.
Getting picked apart.
Yeah, he's losing. He's losing right now because he's standing at bay trying to fight technique for technique with Israel Adesanya.
With intelligence, we have to win this round because the fight is really close.
All right, third and final round here, and we got all hands on deck tonight. Let's bring in welterweight champ Tyron Woodley.
Right now, you see Vettori, he's got to go in kill mode. He could be down two rounds. Now he's going desperate for the takedown. Earlier, he was going for the shot. He never locked his hands on the defense and was defending quite well.
Well, I think, Tyron, Vettori is definitely down two rounds, and he needed this takedown. He did a good job.
This should have been the approach of Vettori from round one,
right?
Getting close, wearing on.
So it's good. Vittori's fighting well. He's a little outmatched in the technique here.
At least in terms of the significant strikes landed, the unofficial numbers very close. Adesanya 47, Vettori 43 and counting.
Yeah, and it's a good match. I mean, it's equal. This is a real test for Adesanya. It's not as easy as he thought it was going to be. Vettori came out and put a great fight, and it's been fun to watch. And we saw a lot of different stuff from Adesanya that people can use in this division to study him.
So for the first time in Israel Adesanya's 13-fight pro mixed martial arts career, he will need to rely on the judges to get his hand raised tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. Derek Cleary scores the contest 29-28 Adesanya. Chris Lee scores it 29-28 Vettori. And Chris Hayes scores the contest 29-28 for the winner by split decision, Israel the Last Style Bender Adesanya.
I mean, last time I came in here, I said I'm the new dog and I pissed all over his cage. Next time, I shit on your grave.
Ciao ragazzi, faccio questo video per informarvi di quello che sta succedendo. Il 6 agosto l'USADA è venuta e mi ha fatto un test. Chi di dovere è venuto a casa mia, mi ha fatto un test, io l'ho accolto a casa come al solito, senza nessun tipo di problema. Ha fatto il test e circa due settimane dopo vengo informato della mia positività ad una sostanza che era vietata, che è vietata. E casco dalle nuvole ovviamente, perché non ho mai fatto uso di sostanze vietate in alcun modo. Casco dalle nuvole, mi dispiace al profondo del cuore, sono veramente amareggiato di questa cosa, però purtroppo nella vita accadono queste cose qua e sono sicuro di superarlo. Non mi sono mai fermato di allenarmi e continuerò a farlo, continuerò a migliorare e sarò pronto per il momento in cui potrò tornare in gabbia.
This is the Schmo with the pro UFC middleweight Marvin Vettori, Kings MMA, Huntington Beach, California. How we doing?
I'm doing very good, man. Can't wait to fight. We 8 weeks out right now, this Monday, so we're good. Very good.
Fighting July 13th, UFC Sacramento. It's been a little over a year since we've last seen you in the octagon, itching to get back in.
Absolutely, yeah. It's been a year where, like, the main focus was just improving and just be calm and trust the process of the USADA, and finally it's over. So I'm very happy to be back, and I can't wait to showcase the improvement that I did in this last year.
Now, the last time we saw you, you took Israel Adesanya to a decision, man. Good experience for you.
Yeah, and I think it was the wrong decision, but still, like, you know, it's it was a. I'm looking forward. I'm not looking backwards. I know that before or later I'm gonna catch him again, and this time I won't leave it to the judges. But you know, that's the past. He had his run, and now he's there. So obviously, I have a few fights before I get him again. But yeah, for sure, I know what happened that day in the cage. He knows it too, and so yeah, it's just a matter of time, honestly. But I'm looking. I'm very focused about on my next fight now, and step by step, I'll get what is mine, and it's just a matter of time, like I said.
We'll get to your next fight against Cesar Ferreira in one moment here, but here at Kings MMA, this is where Calvin Gastelum trains. He just fought Israel Adesanya. Did you help him prepare for that fight?
Yeah, we always train together. We are sparring, like we're teammates, so we spar a lot together. And yeah, man, like Calvin Gastelum, it's he put on a great performance. The fight was great, and yeah, he got close to winning too. Now, you know, he almost dropped him a couple, like he wobbled him a couple of times, and yeah, I mean,
high kick to the head. Yes.
Calvin, like I said, he just needs to feel good. He's gonna perform and do some crazy stuff in there. So he did good. It's just yeah, like, you know, Israel is a good striker, so you can't underestimate him. And but I think, like, with the improvement that I did now, I don't think he's gonna make it to the end of the fight. So it's just a matter of time.
We'll get you out of here on this. What's your one message for all your fans?
You guys tune in on the 13th of July, because it's gonna be fireworks.
That's Marvin Vettori. Oh, yeah. He's the pro. I'm the schmo. We're out.
2 weeks to go. How do you feel?
Good, man. Weight is okay, as you say. Yeah, I feel the best I ever felt, honestly, yeah. We're ready here.
Just less than a year ago, he was fighting Israel Adesanya. He actually lost that fight by split decision, meaning one judge thought he won, so let's not take him lightly.
Taking it all in is Marvin, the Italian Dream Vettori from Trento, Italy, but has moved to California, trains at Kings MMA, calls Kelvin Gastelum a training partner. His last appearance came in April of 2018, an extended layoff he dealt with a six-month USADA suspension because of a tainted supplement. First assignment of the night for the veteran Herb Dean as we get set to go here in the middleweight division. Our UFC Fight Night on ESPN Plus, our main card starts.
Definitely changed over the years, you know. Unfortunately, when you get caught with a couple of solid punches and get knocked out, we'll do that to you. Joe shaking his head. Stumbled it backwards. And lands one of his arms.
Nice left on the break. As levels and gets Fajeda to his back once again.
Picks up on the feet. He's taking some damage.
Slips down. Puts himself in harm's way.
Yeah, talking of damage.
I wanted to come in here, make a statement. I'm back. Last fight was whatever, but now that guy is the interim champ. I'm back for good, man. Put some respect on his name.
The guy, he went all, was it five rounds?
No, three rounds.
Three rounds of, what's the champion, Israel?
Oh yeah, Israel.
Did they have a rematch?
Absolutely, I'm looking forward to
the rematch.
I'll fuck him up.
Choke him out, knock him out.
Beat him every second, like, every
If Israel's second. Watching, what do you tell him?
He knows what I'm gonna tell him. He's a fucking pussy and I can't wait to beat him up.
And Marvin had a lot to say about you after the fact.
He's a fucking juice head, man. He's probably pissed that his cycle got thrown off. You know, the guy got busted for steroids like two fights back, so he's got a big mouth and he's overconfident. He's a kid, you know, he's a little immature. But he's a good fighter, man. And I'm a good fighter, and it's gonna be a tough fight, and we're both gonna be tested. And, you know,
best man from out on top that day.
Brings the professional record standing at 13 victories, 4 defeats, and 1 draw. Fighting out of Mantua, Corona, Italy. Here is Marvin, the Italian Dream Vettori!
Marvin Vettori is a minus 420 favorite in this matchup. Andrew Sanchez has more than 3-1 as the underdog in red.
Sanchez claiming that Vettori is a juice head. That's what he called him. Now, obviously, another Vettori. They're talking away. Oh, beautiful double jab by hand. Wow.
Top Vettori swings big again.
Look at that. Oh, I'll tell you what, Vettori looks amazing here. Fast, powerful strikes. That's a good knee to the body.
The up to go. Vettori stayed up.
Beautiful boxing. Oh, he's hurt. He's hurt.
He tries that knee up the middle, and Vettori has Sanchez pinned on the fence.
Go to the body with a fist. Look at that, Sanchez like that. You ain't got nothing.
Back to the body, and now Sanchez kind of on the run there.
From Italy, Marvin, the Italian Dream Vettori.
The WHO not confirming, but also not ruling out a coronavirus. Any more details from Chinese authorities?
Chinese experts reportedly found a new coronavirus that traces back to the outbreak that we are seeing in Wuhan.
Over in China, the death toll from the virus rises while the disease continues to spread across the world.
I don't know. Is Fight Island part of the deal you already have with Abu Dhabi, or is it a completely separate thing?
No, it's separate, yeah. We did a 5-year deal with those guys to bring fights out there. Then all of a sudden, the world goes to shit, you know, and I'm like, yeah, can I borrow your fucking island? Let's go, round one.
This fight clock is brought to you by Modelo. Wow, I'm going with the kick around.
Nice.
Then they go in.
Man, he's trying to go for the single leg, but Robertson taking it off. He's got the neck. Okay, good job from Vettori to fight off that choke. That was dangerous
there.
Yeah,
he did have the arm under the chin momentarily. Vettori's got the chin there.
Be tight. Nice job. Scramble. Got more flesh in this fight, too. Just starting to sweat. He's got the neck again. That's pretty tight.
Nice job. Acrobatic. This time he can't spin out of it.
Nice work here from Vettori. To use that leg, gets underneath. And Thomas gets the fight that Vettori wants. He wants to keep these exchanges scrambling. Beautiful ground and pound here. Stamping. He's got to get out of there.
The submission for him.
Vettori's got to be careful with this and punch himself out here. He's always blocking a lot of these shots.
Got a win in there for Bergliotta. 45 seconds to work to Robinson. And a tap up at the hand. There's the tap. Takes less than a round to take care of it.
No! Marvin, the Italian Dream. Vettori!
Let's fucking go!
Let's go!
And now I'm here with the winner, Marvin Vettori. Marvin, the emotion on your face says it all. This has been a long journey for you, dating all the way back to March. Then we were in Florida. It didn't happen. How happy are you to get in the octagon and get a W?
6 months of hard fucking work from January, man. Almost like didn't even have a fucking beer since January because of this, you know? Because I'm like this. I'm kind of fucking autistic when it comes to training and preparing for fights. So just saying, like, I just trained so hard and this is my reward, you know, that's all I want, that's my life. I was just so hyped up before the fight, I almost wanted to cry because this is what I love to do, man. Honestly, man, I think I'm the best in the world.
Well,
So, yeah.
You're proving that more and more tonight, and that's three in a row for you. And you said, and I heard you shouting out to Danny, you want top 15 next. I think you've earned that. Is there anybody in particular, and when would you like to get back in?
Listen, everybody's been dodging me, man. Now I don't think they can hide anymore. I have some support about home, the back of my name. And, man, let's fucking go. Like, I want names. I want to climb back to a title shot and get my rematch with Adesanya. It was so close, we have to redo it. No matter who says I won and who says he won it, we have to redo that. He speaks more about me than anybody else, and I'm not even ranked yet. So, fuck yeah, man, we got to do it again, and I have to climb myself all the way up.
Marvin, that was a dominant performance. Congratulations again. Marvin Vettori,
I won my
everyone.
First 50 Gs on my UFC fight. I had 8 fights with today. Never had like a...
Just don't come to me for it. I'm not the man. Go talk to Dana.
I'm going to go back to Dana. I'm going to
Congratulations, Marvin. Beautiful job, buddy.
Thank you, Paul.
All right, have the bleep button ready for Marvin Vettori, but trying to get that bonus and stiff competition for that tonight, but a big performance for the Italian.
Well-rounded is definitely a way to describe him, but can you be more specific? What's he really good at?
Well, I mean, he is good at everywhere. I mean, well-rounded, but he takes guys down. And when he takes guys down, his ground and pound presents opportunities where he seizes with his submission. But if his submission's not enough, he can take you down on his feet. He's a tough night out.
How we doing?
We've been great, man. After the wins, I feel like a fucking lion again, man.
Yeah, everybody heard it. When he got on the scale, he let out a big yell.
6, the Let's official weight for Marvin Vettori.
It's my first main event, and I'm looking forward to just make up a masterpiece Saturday. Tomorrow, yeah.
Yes, and you have to avenge the loss of teammate Calvin Gastelum. I imagine you were helping him to prepare for his fight against the Joker when he was fighting him in Fight Island.
Jack the Joker!
Number one ahead, maximum 3 fives at 185. There is Jack the Joker Hermansson looking focused. Kelvin Gastelum looking ready as well.
Ready.
First outing of 2020 for both of these guys.
Now he's backing Hermansson up, which is what he needs to do. He's got to eliminate that six inch reach advantage.
Nice reversal. With Gastelum, he's got a hold of this leg here. He's looking for a heel hook.
Right leg.
He's got it. He's a scary man when he wins a fight, isn't he?
Me and Jack go back on a long way. Like, we actually fought in the same show outside the UFC a couple times. So I know how he fights. I've been looking at him for a while, and he's been looking at me for a while too. So, yeah, man, he's going to be a good one.
And a big storyline for this fight is his grappling, but a lot of people don't talk about your grappling. You have more submission victories as a pro than he does.
Yeah, exactly.
Why is that being overlooked?
It's by far, because the only thing he has is grappling. I bring the whole package, so that's why they talk about his grappling, but my grappling is better than his. I totally believe that. So it's I think it's fun. You know, I have to prove it on Saturday, but I will.
If you get the job done Saturday evening, they got the rankings coming out on Tuesday. Certainly you'd see a top 5 number next to your name. What's going to be the feels and the expectations for the camp of Marvin Vettori?
I'm totally focused on Saturday for now, but I know I'm going to be right there in the mix, and it's going to be fun, man. Like, whenever they're going to be talk about title contention, my name will be in the discussion. So be good.
Final message for the Italian Dream fans out there worldwide.
Let's tune in Saturday, because it'll be a masterpiece by me.
1, 1, 2.
You see the number 12 next to Marvin Vettori's name. 11 first round finishes. Hardest guy to hit, at least statistically, among active UFC middleweights. In terms of the championship hunger, I know a lot of fighters have it, Dom, but you saw his eyes light up when I mentioned that word hunger, because when he looks for advantages for himself over the rest of this middleweight division, he believes he wants it more than most of these guys.
You know, it's so hard with guys. It's like you said, the only thing you can do is look in their eyes and see the way that they say it, the way that they mean it, because all of us really believe that
that in our heart, that we want it more than the other person. So there's no actual fact to prove that except for yourself in your own head. And when you look at Vettori, you tell him he doesn't believe it. Some numbers on Jack Hermanson, finisher of the highest order, 17 of his 21 pro wins. He has ended, 10 of which have come in the opening round. That includes his last effort against Kelvin Gastelum in July. And if books are any indication, Paul, he is in outstanding physical condition tonight.
Insane. And just, I mean, the reach that this guy has and shredded to the bone is a dangerous, dangerous middleweight. And this fight's exciting, man. I really like, I mean, obviously you don't ever want to see a fight fall out, but if this is the replacement that we're going to get, a motivated, hungry Vettori to go in there and try to take this moment. Exciting stuff.
It's time! 5 rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of Mezza Corona, Italy, Marvin, the Italian Dream, Vettori! Now introducing his opponent, fighting out of Oslo, Norway, by way of Uddevalla, Sweden, Jack the Joker Hermansson!
All right, gentlemen, we've been over the rules. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We're going to keep it clean. Touch gloves when it's done.
The intensity of the UFC main event, nothing like it. Jack Hermanson and Bruce Buffer had a little moment there.
That was good. That was good. Yeah, Buff loves that, man. He was loving that one.
Number 12 in the world, but favored tonight against fourth-ranked Jack Hermanson. This
Jay's got a good bounce in his step. But Marvin doing a really good job of pressuring in and closing his distance.
Very patient, too. He's usually patient. And a nice uppercut that left hand keeps landing, too. Nice, how important that foot battle is.
Hermanson there, though.
Nice job. Oh, the hand speed of Marvin Vettori on display. Round one.
Yeah, and it's gone quick because this fight is awesome. One takedown.
Nice.
Oh, yes.
But return right away from Vettori.
You guys are just hopefully fighting right now, right in the pocket.
Oh, got early him. Knockdown from Marvin Vettori. Hermanson covering up.
Hermanson trying to recover. This is what he does so well. He keeps damaging. He's not going to look to squeeze.
Oh, nah, no, he likes this guillotine.
He's in half guard here, so it's going to be hard to finish. And now he's going to get back to the damage.
Late uppercut lands for Hermanson, but a strong start for Vettori. Create your account at UFCFightPass.com and instantly get the winter preview is live now. Nice slip there by Vettori and counters with his own offense.
Single leg, Hermanson moves his head to the outside of the high crotch again. And now he's back on a single, trying to finish it like a single. He does it, let's see what he can do with it. He's trying to transition now to a double leg.
Wow.
Vettori hits a switch and transitions
it. Vettori trying to leverage and get on a hip to escape. And now,
gets back up.
And immediately greeted with a jab from Vettori that splits the guard. Now a shot to the body. Oh, nice stick by Vettori.
Feels like he sees some openings. Great coaching. Look for the body shot, which is there, especially being a southpaw. There it is.
Hermanson super aggressive on the feet here early round three. Vettori with an effective body attack there, and Hermanson lands up top.
Yeah, he's got to be careful slipping back like that against Hermanson.
Third round for Jack Hermanson.
It's back and forth this whole round. I would say Hermanson landed probably about 10 shots more, as you can see on the numbers.
Yeah, rounds one and two fairly close. Round three, not so much.
Yeah, he's fighting it on. He's throwing combinations now, not one at a time as much. But Vettori, don't forget about that power at any moment.
Coming up on 150 total throws unofficially this round alone for these two guys. Oh. Power advantage clear for Vettori.
Oh, that left hand is sharp.
Seemingly anybody's fight as we hit this fifth and final round.
That's gonna hurt. These guys are really unbelievable. Put right hooks from Hermanson right here.
Nice.
Oh, man, I love the corner work. I love this fight.
And we could potentially be looking at some historic output here. Both guys have thrown north of 310 total strikes.
They're just taking it on their face right now. They're all just eating shots.
Looks like Marvin's out of it.
Yep.
Ends on top where he wanted.
Wow, what a showcase for the UFC's middleweight division. Jack Hermansson and Marvin Vettori go the distance. We will see which man emerges with the scorecards and the win after this. We are back live in Las Vegas, and I would imagine mixed martial arts fans around the world want to hear the scorecards.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. The judges score the contest 49-46. 49-46 and 49-45 for the winner by unanimous decision, Marvin the Italian Dream Vettori!
What a moment for Marvin Vettori tonight, Paul Felder.
I mean, that's an incredible performance from Marvin Vettori. And it's not like he didn't get met with a motivated, hungry Jack Hermansson as well. Those guys went to battle tonight. That was an absolute five-round back and forth, just beautiful performance. Look at the emotion on his face. You can tell when you interview this young man, he is so motivated, so hungry to become the first Italian champion. It's incredible to see him go in there and perform the way he did, taking this fight, capitalizing on this moment, and doing what he did tonight.
Marvin, congratulations. Obviously a huge win for you and just an absolutely incredible fight. I'm sure the bumps and bruises will probably feel a little worse tomorrow, but give us the idea. Mentally, physically, what's the feeling like for you right now?
It's good, man. Like, even the bruises are good. Like, I enjoyed them in a sense, you know? So, no, it feels good, man. I know I made history tonight, and, you know, it's a big step towards where I want to be. So, it's big. I feel good, man.
Very nice. The last thing for me, Dana was in here earlier, and we said, hey, where do you think this puts Marvin? He said, man, probably top five for sure, you know? So that's just a select couple of names there. So give me an idea. What is the fight that makes sense for you next, and when do you want to do it?
Man, you know, to be honest with you, before I called out Borachinha, but fuck Borachinha, he just came out of a crazy loss. Why would I even fight him? I'm going to go straight to the title, man.
Do you think that Israel would take that fight with you, or do you think he's going to make you keep fighting other guys before he says yes?
Israel is full of shit. Like, he was like, oh, you know, I don't think I will ever see Marvin again. Like, you know, he will never make it to the title. Guess what, motherfucker, I'm here, you know? So, he thinks he has it all figured out. He got nothing figured out. I know his true colors. I know his true colors. I met him a few times. I fought him. I know his true colors. I won that fight.
I'm the hackers in the division, man. If there's one guy out here that wants the title more than everything, like, to be honest, to me, it's the mission of my life for now, you know? This is the mission of my life. My whole life comes down to get that title, and I don't have anything else going on other than chasing this motherfucking title and to be the first Italian UFC champion.
I wake up thinking fighting, I go training thinking fighting, I probably go to sleep thinking fighting. I'm seeking for the belt, seeking to be UFC champion.
I want to be the legitimate number one contender for this fucking title, and then I want to be the one that dethrones that bullshit ass champion called Israel Adesanya.
I definitely want to fight Adesanya and settle the score once for all. My goal out there is to finish the fight, to dominate him, to just show that I'm the next thing in general in the division. There's not going to be no pedestal for him to stay on the moment we walk into that cage.